seeing red. Click, click, can you hear it? Steadily approaching, click. It's the red pen and it's heading straight for your masterpiece. Are you momentarily traumatized when asked to fill a blank page with words? Do you suddenly see red? Those markings across your sixth grade papers have scarred your future. Our dedicated teachers may have unknowingly bludgeoned our creative expression forever with that darn ballpoint pen. At age 5, you got a cookie for coloring inside the lines. At age 6, you got gold stars when you hung the periods properly, but at age 12, you were scolded with X's and not happy faces because you used too many exclamation points and failed to stop your sentences from running wild. By age 16, you started to get the hang of perfection, anything to avoid red. So now, when it's time to get wild and creative, you fidget under your desk. Beady eyes burn the back of your neck. Clicking echoes in your left ear. What if you do something wrong and that pin comes for you? Splat! Too many commas. Don't you need a dash? A hyphen? A capital? A semicolon? My, my, your spelling is atrocious. How old are you again? They let you graduate from university? Before I go on, I need to confess. In 2003, during my first year as a classroom teacher, I graded with the red pen. I just ducked. Let me explain. Feeling conflicted about it, I switched to the black pen. My special needs class of 4th, 5th, and 6th graders presented academic functioning below their grade level. I told them I wasn't a fan of circling and drawing arrows all over their papers in red ink. I thought it demeaning, and I didn't want to blunt their writing confidence any more than the system had already done. To my surprise, the kids wanted the red feedback, complaining they couldn't tell my black pen from their pencil writing. We took a poll, and every student voted red. So I slid the red pick back into my ponytail.